Ginsberg. He was a beat writer. There were two others within, Jack Kerouac and William Burroughs. I have a conviction in their poetry, and that is the reason when my friend told me to come here, I thought to recite a poem that changed the contours of history in America. Beat Generation was a movement in America, and this was the poem that started that revolution. It was a revolution of youth. The young came on the road after listening to this poem. This poem is called Howl. It is a post-war attempt after two world wars, and you have Holocaust and the dropping of the vanishing of entire cities of Hiroshima and Nagasaki.
When you
these
don't know,
come on this scene.
Sana, you don't know the most.
Their contempt for materialism, conformism, and to every word, action, to the use of sex, drugs, and obscene language, they were able to instill the power of revolution among the young people. So first time, this poem actually went through obscenity trials in USA, and this is a poem, a revolution in itself. It was a long poem, so I am not going to read the entire, it will take around half an hour, given the 10 minutes of which I have already wasted 3. So I'll just, have that selected passages for you, because the context I think was very important in order to understand the essence of this poem. This is by Allen Ginsberg. He is writing this poem for his friend Carl Solom, who has been taken forcefully to a mental asylum. So there are words, I'll guide you through them. I saw the best minds of my generation destroyed by madness, starving, hysterical, naked, dragging themselves through the Negro streets at dawn looking for an angry fix. Angel-headed hipsters burning for the ancient heavenly connection to the starry dynamo in the machinery of night. Who poverty and tatters and hollow-eyed hide, sat up smoking in the supernatural darkness of cold water flats floating across the tops of cities contemplating jazz. Who bared their brains to heaven under the L and saw Mohammedan angels staggering on tenement roofs, illuminated. He would be using the word who to describe different sorts of lunatics who were followers of literature. Who passed through universities with radiant cool eyes, hallucinating Arkansas and Lake-like tragedy among the scholars of war. Who were expelled from the academics for crazy and publishing obscene odes on the windows of the skull. Who covered in unshaven rooms in underwear, burning their money in waste baskets and listening to the terror through the wall. Who got busted in their public beards, returning through Laredo with a belt of marijuana in New York. Who ate fire in paint hotels or drank turpentine in Paradise Alley. Death or purgatory, their torsos night after night. With dreams, with drugs, with waking nightmares, alcohol and cock and endless balls. Who talked continuously 70 hours from park to park to bar to Bellevue to museum to Brooklyn Bridge. A lost battalion of platonic conversationalists jumping down the stoops of fire escapes off windowsills of Empire State out of the moon. Yakti-yakking, screaming, vomiting, whispering facts and memories and anecdotes and eyeball kicks and shocks of hospitals and jails and wars. Who wandered around and around at midnight in the railroad yard, wondering where to go and when, leaving no broken heart. Who lit cigarettes in boxcars, racketing through snow toward lonesome farms in grandfather night. Who studied Plotinus, Poe, St. John of the Cross, telepathy, Bob Kabbalah. Because the cosmos instinctively vibrated at their feet in Kansas. Who loaned through the streets of Idaho seeking visionary Indian angels who were visionary Indian angels. Who disappeared into the volcanoes of Mexico, leaving behind nothing but the shadows of dungarees and the lava and the ash of poetry scattered in fireplace Chicago. Who burned cigarette holes in their arms, protesting the narcotic tobacco haze of capitalism. Who bit detectives in the neck and shrieked with delight in police cars for committing no crime but their own wild cooking, pederasty and intoxication. Who howled on their knees in the subway and were dragged off the roof waving gentles and manuscripts. who let themselves be fucked in the ass by saintly motorcyclists and screamed with joy, who bawl in the morning, in the evenings, in rose gardens, in the grass of public parks and cemeteries, scattering their semen freely to whoever comes, who may, who hiccuped endlessly, trying to giggle, but wound up with a sob behind a partition in a Turkish bath, when the blonde and naked angel came to pierce them with a sword, who copulated ecstatic and incessant with a bottle of beer, a sweetheart, a packet of cigarettes, a candle, and fell off the bed, and continued along the floor and down the hall, and ended fainting on the wall with a vision of ultimate content sun, eluding the last drizzle of consciousness. Who wept at the romance of the streets with the pushcarts full of onions and bad music, who coughed on the sick floor of Harlem, crowned with flame under the tubercular sky surrounded by orange grapes of theology, who scribbled all night, rocking and rolling over lofty incantations, which in the yellow morning were stanzas of gibberish, who cooked rotten animals, lung, heart, feet, tail, borscht, and tortilla, dreaming of pure vegetable kingdom, who plunged themselves under meat trucks looking for an egg, who threw their watches off the roof to cast their ballot for eternity outside of time, and alarm clocks fell on their heads every day for the next decade. In the second part of the poem, he is calling out to his friend, just read it off. Akal, while you are not safe, I am not safe. And now you are really in the total animal soup of time. With the absolute heart of the poem of life butchered out of their own bodies, good to eat 1,000 years. Now he's referring to America, the consumer industry, as Moloch. Moloch is a god that was also mentioned for the first time in Paradise Lost by Milton. And he is the god who demands sacrifice, blood of children. So he calls this capitalism Moloch. Ginsberg says, Moloch, solitude, filth, ugliness, ash cans and unobtainable dollars, children screaming under the stairways, boys sobbing in armies, old men weeping in the pot. Moloch, Moloch, nightmare of Moloch, Moloch, the loveless, mental Moloch, Moloch, the heavy, judger of men, Moloch, whose mind is pure machinery, Moloch, whose blood is running money. Moloch, whose fingers are 10 armies, Moloch, whose breast is a cannibal dynamo. Moloch, whose ears is a smoking tomb, Moloch, whose eyes are 1,000 blind windows. Moloch, whose skyscrapers stand in the long streets like endless Jehovah's. Moloch, whose factories dream and croak in the fog. Moloch, whose love is endless oil and stone. Moloch, whose soul is electricity and banks. Moloch, whose poverty is a specter of genius. Moloch, whose fate is the cloud of sexless hydrogen. Moloch, whose name is the mind. Moloch, in whom I sit lonely. Moloch, in whom I dream angels. Crazy in Moloch, cocksuckered in Moloch, lack love and manless in Moloch. Moloch, who entered my soul early. Moloch, in whom I'm a conscience. Moloch, Moloch, robot apartments, invisible suburbs, skeleton treasures, blind capitals, cocks, monstrous bombs. They broke their back lifting Moloch to heaven, pavement, trees, radios, turns, lifting the city to heaven, which exists and is everywhere in us. Carl Solem, this is the third part. Now he's referring to his friend. He was taken to Rockland. Rockland is the name of that mental asylum. He says, Carl Solem, I'm with you in Rockland, where you are madder than I am. I'm with you in Rockland, where you must feel strange. I'm with you in Rockland, where you imitate the shade of my mother. I'm with you in Rockland, where the faculties of the skull no longer admit the worms of the senses. I'm with you in Rockland, I'm with you in Rockland, where you scream in a straitjacket that you are losing the game of the actual ping pong of the abyss. I'm with you in Rockland. I'm with you in Rockland. O starry spangled shock of mercy, the eternal war is here. O victory, forget your underwear. We are free. And finally, this after a year, he adds a fourth part to Howl. This is actually sung by him. He says, holy, 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 holy. The world is holy, the soul is holy, the skin is holy, the nose is holy, the tongue and cock and hand and as whole is holy. Everything is holy, everybody is holy, everywhere is holy, every day is an eternity. Every man's an angel, the bum's as holy as the seraphim, the madman is holy as you, my soul are holy. The typewriter is holy, the poem is holy, the voice is holy, the hearers are holy, the ecstasy is holy. Holy Peter, holy Alan, holy Solomon, holy Lucian, holy Kerouac, holy Hung, holy Burroughs, holy Cassidy. Holy the unknown, buggered and suffering beggars, holy the hideous human angels. Holy my mother in the insane asylum. Holy the cocks of the grandfathers of Kansas. Holy the groaning saxophone. Holy the bop apocalypse. Holy the jazz bands, marijuana, hipsters, peace, peyote, pipes and drums. Holy the solitude of skyscrapers and pavements. Holy the cafeterias filled with millions. Holy the mysterious rivers of tears under the streets. Holy New York, holy San Francisco, holy Peoria and Seattle, holy Paris, holy Tangiers, holy Moscow, holy Istanbul. Holy is the sea, holy the desert, holy the railroad, holy the locomotive, holy the visions, holy the hallucinations, holy the miracles, holy the eyeball, holy the abyss. Holy forgiveness, mercy, charity, faith, holy ours, body, suffering, magnanimity. Holy, the supernatural, extra brilliant, intelligent kindness of the soul. Thank you.